Hello there. In this video, we're going to be talking about the online registration of copyright in Nigeria. You can do this offline in any copyright commission close to you in your state, but this video is going to be about an online registration. If you're not well versed in copyright, I advise you get a lawyer who should be well versed in intellectual property issues to do this registration for you. So go straight into the video. There are so many copyright websites online and it might confuse you. So this is the correct website for Nigeria's Copyright Commission. When you get into the website, you're going to be faced with this. I suggest you copy it out or take a screenshot of it because this is going to help you in your remitter generation and in activating your login for this registration. And so we get that on our phones and move straight into the next, which is creating an account. So when I click on that, or when you click on that, this is what you're going to be faced with: your personal details, address details. These are things you're going to fill out for the creation of your account. You notice the things in red asterisk. They are things that are very pertinent to your registration. If you do not fill them, or you fill them incorrectly, they're going to affect your account creation. And when you're done with that, you click the recapture button and then you submit. You might want to head straight to login, but you're going to be faced with this on your screen. So you remember the email I asked you to screen grab in the beginning? Yes, you're going to be sending an email to that email, which is your username and your password, and within 24 to 48 hours you should be getting this kind of email, which shows that your account is activated and so you can log in and head in straight for your registration. Now, this is what your dashboard should look like. So just to be very sure, I'm going to click on my profile to be sure that this is my page. Yep, it is mine. You should do that to be sure that that is yours. So going back to my dashboard, let's look around. Now, where you would register is where you see this register a new work on the top left part of your dashboard. Now, let me explain what is in front of you before we go back to that side. Now, pending application means you just submitted your application and it's pending like a review or a look by someone in the commission. Then queried application means you made a mistake, something doesn't tally and it requires you to correct it, or some sort of mistake you made. That is why you should be very careful. So saved application means that they have successfully looked at it and no mistake has been made, and then you are almost headed to approval. So when you get to approval, you are ready. So looking at your top left screen, let's go right into what they entail. Now, this part is very important. It is pertinent to note that an author and a copyright owner may not necessarily be the same person. While an author is someone who created a particular work that you want to copyright, a copyright owner might not be the creator. There are so many reasons for this particular difference in meaning, which is why it's advised you get a lawyer to prevent mistakes. Like I said earlier, the things marked in red asterisks are core to your registration, so you make sure you fill them up. Now, you see that section that says select work type? We're going to talk about it now. So because you can copyright all kinds of things that you have created, naturally they should have different types in which they come in. So you select that which applies to your right and then fill it in. And then you see the title of work. The rule here says that if it has no title, you leave it untitled. Likewise, you use the title when it has one. So I want us to look at this medium of fixation. Now, it is that way in which the particular work is preserved, whether it's in a paper or a DVD or whatever you have. And we're going straight to the zonal office. This is very pertinent because this is where you're going to be collecting your certificate. You don't want to be in another state and be picking another state for your collection. So when you pick the state that applies to your registration and your comfort, obviously, you're going to click the save and the next button, which will take you to the next step when you look at it on your top left. We're going to go into that now. So you click the save and the next button. Yeah. So it takes you to co-owners information. You fill accordingly and you click the save and the next button. For each step you save and click the next button, it takes you chronologically to the next. It is he or she whose name you fill in here that is going to be the author or the owner of this particular right that you are registering. So you have to be very careful. Another thing is to look at the size of the part of this registration, because for every section you get into after you click the save and the next button, you're going to see the tips that guide a particular side which you must follow and adhere to. This is the next, obviously, so you feel accordingly. As you know, when the person has copyrighted a work and you want to use his work, you have to seek his or her permission. So this correspondence is the person with whom such information is to be given to. That is, you seek permission from this person to gain license to use that particular right you are asking for. And that person can be in any part of the world, so you feel accordingly. So whether the copyright was transferred or not, you have to feel accordingly. Then you click the save and the next button. The work disposition, deposition rather. Now in this part, you have to be very careful because it says it has to be a maximum of 20 MB. That is, you have to upload the particular work and submit to the commission. Like you can see here, there are rules that even says that audio should be submitted in an MP3 format, so you should pay attention to the tips given in each section. The declaration you feel as required, then you click the save and the next button. Please note that according to the rules of the commission, if you want to make a deposit in the bank, you should make the deposit in the bank before you begin this online registration. But if you want to make the deposit through an online procedure, you can come straight here. It is 10,000 naira for the application for this registration. Other things have other fees, which I will be showing you next. So you can see these are the various fees for the various things. For works fixated in paper, the higher your papers are, the higher your fees will be. So these are the fees. You can take a screen grab or go to the website. The information is there. You can also use a scratch card if you don't want to do an online payment or the remitter payment through a deposit in the bank. Now, you remember that picture that we screen grabbed in the beginning? This is where it comes in for your payment. So to generate a remitter, definitely you have to go to remitter.net and click on pay the federal government, and you follow the steps. These are step-by-step information you're going to need for the various things you're going to fill on the remitter website. You can take a screen grab of this for less hassle. Please ensure to proofread, as making mistakes and correcting them attract these fees. Thank you for watching. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. Share this video to someone you know this will help. Someone you know this will be very beneficial to. Don't keep it to yourself. Remember to ask me questions in the comment section. I could just be making the next video for you. Thank you as you do this. See you next time in my video. Goodbye.